A reputable official named Zhang Boaxing was mentioned in the book The Draft History of Qing. He spent most of his life as an official in prosperous places, but he always lived a simple life and maintained himself as a frugal scholar. In March 2014, Xi Jinping told the story of Zhang at a meeting with local officials in Lancao, on other days. Xi said there was a well-known Queen official named Zhang Boaxing in the history of Lancao. He had successfully held the high-ranking posts of Governor of Fujian, Governor of Jiangsu, Minister of Rights, and in order to reject gifts from different parties, he wrote a rebate to express his principles.
他其实有像当时这个吴国的官场发出一种很怒吼的一种姿态，可以说是平静的湖面扔进了一颗大石头进去，产生了一个巨大的连锁效应。
Born in 1651, Zhang passed the Imperial Civil Service Examination in 1685 and became an official and worked for Emperor Kangxi of Qing Dynasty. In 1707, he was appointed as An Chasha of Jiangsu Province, a provincial surveillance commissioner to supervise local judicial administration.
Zhang Boaxing to Suzhou来当这个江苏安察使的时候，那么他就必须要想总督巡抚要送礼，要送多少呢？ 大概相当于要4000两银子，这笔钱相当于江苏安察使20年的工资收入，所以他如果说要送礼，只能是从老百姓那个地方给收过来，而张不行呢，愿不愿意这样做？他说我从来不取官民分钱，哪里能够办得了这样一种事情呢？
Qiangnan is the largest examination hall for Imperial Civil Service examination in ancient China. In 1711, a provincial examination result published here uncovered one of China's most infamous scandals, the Jiangnan cheating scandal. Dozens of examinees from rich salt merchants' families bribed the examiners and thus passed the exam. Hundreds of people gathered outside the hall and protested, which caused a widespread public outcry. At that time, Zhang had been promoted to the governor of Jiangsu, and it was his duty to investigate the case. The process was very complex and difficult because several high-ranking officials were involved in briberies and related crimes. One of the suspected officials was Gawi, who was the viceroy of Liangzhang, the governor general of three Yangtze provinces, including Jiangsu, Anhui, and Jiangxi. He had much more power than Zhang. Zhang risked his reputation and career to seek the truth. After several months' investigation, he finally brought corrupted officials to justice. Gao was ultimately dismissed from his post. During his more than 40-year political career, Zhang built schools, battled famine, lawfully punished bullies, and cleansed the local administration. He was highly praised by the people during his time in office.
当官就不要发财，发财就不要当官，清清爽爽的，义无反顾的去当官。张伯行的故事，主要是勉励我们广大党员干部，树立正确的政绩观，从小节上严加防范，清清白白做人，干干净净做事，坦坦荡荡为官。